we are all awaiting the budget for the year 2019-2020 from the new finance minister, Mr. Piyush Goyal, who has temporarily taken charge from Mr. Jaitley. Now, the textile industry is right now grappling with two major issues. One is the trade war between US and China, due to which there is a major disruption in the trade models, in the economies of the emerging nations, and in the trade relations between countries. So the demand for yarn and fabric has fallen, and against that the prices of cotton have gone down. This could be a good thing for the industry, but the industry is not happy because the supply chain is bleeding actually. On the other side, there is the farmer distress. This has been a year of drought for India, a very scanty rainfall year, due to which the crop yield has fallen. Due to the low yield of cotton, the crop is expected to fall by not less than 8 to 10% in the season 2018-19. So both ways, industry wise and farmer wise, the year till now doesn't look very promising unless things change for the better post the trade war. So what should happen in the new budget that can help the industry, especially the agriculture industry, the farmers growing cotton? Cotton plays an important role in Indian economy. The country's textile industry is predominantly cotton based. India is one of the largest producers as well as exporters of cotton yarn. The textile industry is expected to reach US$223 billion by the year 2021. It is also the highest employment generating industry after agriculture. Although India is the largest producer of cotton, it covers nearly 25% of world share and the second largest consumer and exporter of cotton, Indian cotton market faces the two main challenges of low yield and contamination, such that many farmers, ginners, exporters and spinners are facing survival issues. Yields in India are lower by about 200 to 300% compared to other cotton producing countries who are India's competitors, like US, China, Brazil, Australia. 70% of Indian cotton farmers spend more than what they earn, as low yield and crop losses due to diseases arising out of long duration crops have put severe limitations on the income of these farmers. Farmers are losing money growing cotton, and agriculture is becoming more of a liability for them. There is rising distress amongst farmers, which may prove to be fatal for the textile industry and the country on the whole. If the government and the textile industry does not focus on increasing the yield and quality of Indian cotton, we may never see the acche din for farmers and industry in the near future. So things are serious, friends, and serious measures have to be taken. Looking at the yield, production and consumption figures of cotton in India in the last 6 years, I can confidently say that India will become a net importer of cotton in the next 3 years. We need to address the situation of poor yields and seed cotton at sub-standard quality of Indian cotton bales, so that it is not discounted, with an iron hand to regain the glory of Indian cotton textile industry. We need to rediscover the economics of Indian cotton. This can contribute to the national GDP, increasing income of farmers and all stakeholders of the cotton textile industry, create more employment for the nation, ensuring cotton textile industry of uninterrupted supply of quality cotton. So much investment is happening in textile, has already happened in textiles. Just imagine, friends, if we do not receive quality cotton in time, if there is an disruption in the supply of cotton, things can be very, very dicey for the textile industry, and farmers are not happy. For this, COTTONGURU strongly recommends four things from the government in the current budget of 2019-20. Best quality of seeds. There is no dispute that seeds are the main source of increasing the yield and the production as well as the quality. So the farmers are entitled to best quality latest technology seeds. So the government must allocate a special budget, a very huge budget, for research in the seeds, so that the farmers get the best quality of seeds suitable for Indian agroclimatic condition. These seeds must be of a higher ginning outcome, so that farmers realize better prices and ginners are happy to pay the higher prices to the farmers. So best quality of seeds suitable to Indian agroclimatic conditions with a higher ginning outcome. That is the primary requirement in this budget. Provision of 24 hours of power for the agriculture. Agriculture must be considered as an industry like any other industry, And like any other industry, it is entitled to 24 hours power supply. Power during the daytime will encourage more and more young farmers to come into farming, will give more access to laborers, to vendors who can give their best technology services to farming, and this will help increase the production as well as the yield. Over the shelf subsidy for drip irrigation, the situation is not common across all states. If we see the benefits of irrigation, it should be a national policy. Over the shelf subsidy of at least 50, if not 75%, to help increase the yield and the prosperity of farmer. This will save a lot of water and cost of drawing water during drought year like the year 2018. And the last point would be at least 50% incentives and subsidies on cost effective value addition of cotton, cotton seeds, cotton stocks, promoting agri SMEs in villages. We need to increase rural employment. We need to bring the people from city, the entrepreneurs from cities to the villages, create more entrepreneurship in the rural areas. This will help in generating more employment and entrepreneurship, restraining the migration to cities, decreasing the load on the cities. So the four suggestions of COTTONGURU for the budget, if they are addressed, I am sure are going to be a game changers for the cotton and the textile industry. But till Mr. Piyush Goyal releases the new budget, best wishes from COTTONGURU to all the farmers and all stakeholders of the cotton industry.